Coming up, we look at what's changed for Office client deployment, with Click to Run now the only installation option for Office. We'll look at what gets better with the new Office client policy service and the new Office customization tool, including fast and predictable removal of previous installed MSI packages, and how, combined with System Center Configuration Manager, you get a greatly improved and single integrated process for Office deployments with Click to Run. If you've deployed Office client for your organization in the past, you'll know that with previous versions of Office, there were two primary paths for installation. You could choose to either deploy a version of Office with MSI packaging or a version of Office using Click-to-Run packaging. Many of you may have chosen to use the MSI package. It's familiar, had great customization options, and an affinity with volume activation. Moving forward, all current versions of Office, including Visio and Project, will only use Click-to-Run for installation. And with our new tools, you can still perform granular configurations. Simplifying Office in a single package makes it easier to install and gives you simpler management without giving up controls that you're used to. So let's start by walking through the experience with the new Office customization tool for Click-to-Run. You can get this tool by going to config.office.com. Now, if you've used OCT in the past, the difference here is that you don't need Office installation files to get started. In this release of the tool, you'll first be prompted to choose between the 32-bit and 64-bit versions of Office. Then you can select which Office suite or product you want to include. And here you can even see the volume licensing versions are available. We'll select Office 365 Pro Plus. You will now notice that I'm given the ability to choose which apps I want to keep and exclude. In this case, I want to exclude Access and Publisher. As I move through the process, my configuration gets updated on the right. Next, I'll select Channel. A channel refers to the frequency in which Office features will be updated. You can choose to receive updates monthly or twice a year. Targeted means that you've opted for early access to features that your IT team and pilot groups can test in advance, something we highly recommend. For now, I'll select semi-annual for broad production deployment. And next, I'm prompted to choose the version of Office that I want. I'll select the latest. And now, I'm prompted to select the primary language. One tip here. You'll want to be discerning of your language selections to avoid increasing your package size, which in turn will increase deployment costs due to bandwidth requirements. I'm going to choose English, and I can choose a secondary language. We recommend selecting Match Operating System if you're installing directly from the CDN. Next, you choose where you want to deploy Office, from either the cloud or a local source, which is a shared location that I know my targeted PCs can have access to, or I can choose Configuration Manager option, which I'm going to do in this case. From here, we move on to upgrade options. First, I'm asked where I want to deploy updates from. In my case, I'll select Configuration Manager. Now, I'm prompted to select my upgrade options. In the past, if you wanted to remove a previous install of Office, you needed to send out a package to remove those installs. Now you can do all of this cleanly in one step with predictable outcomes. You'll notice it's on by default, and you can select to keep prior versions of the apps individually that you have under the volume licensing. For example, I want to uninstall Office, but I want to keep Visio 2013 for my organization. Now I'll click Next and move on to Licensing and Activation section. Note, if I had chosen a volume suite or individual product of Office, we'd be prompted to choose our product activation type, one to manage the behavior of the EULA, and one to determine if you need shared computer activation. Next, I'll enter my organization's name and any additional descriptions I may need for future reference. After that, I now need to select my app preferences. This offers a major difference to what we've done in the past, as you're able to specify granular user-based preferences. From here, I can search for a specific setting per app and have them be part of the install. For instance, I want to ensure that macros are blocked from running. I'll type macro in the search bar. Click on Block Macros in Office, and then in the dropdown, change the configuration to true. Now it's configured, and I'll hit Finish. Once I've finished selecting my user preference, I can now export my configuration file and use it with my tool of choice to create my deployment package. Now, many of you will probably be using Configuration Manager to do your deployments. The good news is that the OCT tool is natively integrated, and if you wanted to, you could do all the steps I just showed you from the start in Configuration Manager. To get started, my next step is to create an app package for deployment. To do that, I'll first go to the software library, and then the Office 365 client management dashboard, and select the Office 365 installer. First, I'm prompted to name the package and select a current location. Next, I need to launch the Office customization tool. I can now import the XML I just created. The OCT shows a modified layout in Configuration Manager with only applicable options displayed. For example, some installation and upgrade and update settings are pre-configured for your environment. Now I can complete the package creation as usual as with any other app, and I'm ready to deploy. This will now configure Office and your preferences as part of the Office install. Now, one new thing unique to the Office 365 clients is if you want to enforce policies after you've installed Office, the new Office Client Policy Service allows you to manage Office application policies centrally, regardless if the machine is already domain joined and policy managed or enrolled in an MDM environment. To get to the OCPS, you can go to the link shown. Once I'm in the tool, I can see my current policies that are in place. I'll create a new policy for my legal team. I'll select my legal group, then I'll enable policies. In this case, I'll enforce a policy to open RTF files in protected view. I'll search for RTF, click on RTF files in Word. Here, I see the configuration options, and I'll choose to open RTF files in protected view. Now, you may have noticed that the steps here we took look similar to what we did to set preferences in the OCT tool. The main difference is that the Office Client Policy Service is actually enforcing policies. It's running in the cloud and also tied to each user's sign-in in Azure AD, whether or not their device is on your corporate domain. OCT, on the other hand, generates an XML file that instructs the installer to set optional preferences at install time. You will need to use group policies to enforce policies if you aren't using OCPS, or if you want to enforce policies on volume licensing versions of Office. So that was a quick overview of the updates to deploying Office. Now, there are a few other things to mention to look forward to with Click to Run that gives you simpler management. The Click to Run version of Office can also take advantage of delivery optimization to optimize network traffic for updates. And you can also take advantage of the advanced network optimization capabilities in Peer Cache for Configuration Manager. And unlike traditional app servicing, you do not need to push the entire update package to each endpoint. You just need to install the Delta for updates directly from your distribution points. As you shift to this package approach, it's also recommended that you consider Office 365 Pro Plus version of Office, which as a subscription services ensures that you are on the current and the latest productivity capabilities. Don't forget to follow the desktop deployment wheel to get broader tips on deploying Office and Windows 10 for your organization on our Desktop Deployment Essentials series. Finally, if you want to get started with the tools I've shown you today, please go to config.office.com. Thanks for watching.